Hi, I'm Cheryl, and welcome to the Sewing Room Channel. I've got another tip of the week for you, and this is about buttons. A viewer of mine not long ago mentioned to me that she had a lot of buttons that she'd been collecting, but she didn't want to use them on clothing because she doesn't sew clothing, and she wanted to know what she could use those buttons on. So I'm going to show you some of the things that I've added buttons to, and then I'm going to show you how to use a button to maybe help solve a wardrobe problem that you might have. Here is a pillow that I added a button to. So it's got a button on the front in the center, and then it's got another button on the back. So you can use buttons to accentuate and embellish a pillow. Here is a little bag I put together, and I put a button on the flap. Now, it's not a buttonhole, it's not a functioning button. It's just there merely as a decoration, and it just really helps to bring out all of the colors in the fabric. Here is a basket liner that I made, and I used buttons on it. I first put on these little yo-yos, and if you want to know how to make a yo-yo, that's this little fabric circle, check below the YouTube screen for the video link to this. So I put the yo-yo on it, and then the button on top, and it just really adds a lot of personality to basket liners. This is a blouse I recently bought at Walmart, and one of the reasons why I bought it, it was very soft and I loved the pretty color in it. One of the things I didn't like about it was this large neck opening, because I have a little bit of a problem. I'm kind of lopsided. I have one shoulder much higher than the other. So if a blouse or shirt has a wide neck opening, it has a tendency to fall towards my left shoulder and fall off my shoulder sometimes. So I have a really easy way to solve this problem. So I'm going to show you some options that you can use to kind of help close this up a little bit so it still looks fashionable and like it originally came that way. I want to use this blue button in some way. So there's one option I could do is that I could create a loop using this elastic, and this is made by Dritz, D-R-I-T-Z, and it's round cord elastic. So what you could do is cut off a short piece of this and just loop it, stitch it on the back side of the opening, and have it loop around the button. So you would take that round cord elastic, put it on the back side wherever you want your attachment to be, and put the button on the other side. I don't really want to use that option. I want to do something a little different. So I might use something called a ladder stitch. It's a hidden stitch, and I could actually close up this opening either part of the way or all the way up. But I'm not sure if I want to just do that either. So what I think I'm going to do is do the ladder stitch halfway up with the button at the very top, and it'll solve my problem. So let me show you what it looks like. So what do you think? I think it solved my problem, and I think it looks great. I'm very happy with it. It's not falling off my shoulder at all. Make sure you follow me on Instagram and check out my Facebook page. If you would like to hear some of my other sewing tips that I have, check below your YouTube screen for those video links. Also look for links below that have to do with beginner sewing project. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy sewing. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the thumbs up button. And don't forget to click on share to share this video with your friends. If you haven't subscribed yet, click on that red subscribe button down there in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Click on the bell so you can receive notifications about my latest videos. I'm Cheryl, and this is Scotty, and this is Manny. See you next time, and happy sewing!